Let us stand. In his life, Paul knew the cross of Jesus Christ. May he now share in Jesus' victory over sin and death. Let us pray. Lord God, giver of all that is true and lovely and gracious, you created in marriage a sign of your covenant. Look with mercy upon Paul, who was united in love with his wife. May the care and devotion of his life on earth find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on Linda and on Paul's children and his grandchild and all of his family and friends as now they turn to your compassion and love. Strengthen their faith and lighten their loss. Lead Paul into eternal peace and bring him to the table where the saints feast together in your heavenly home through Christ our Lord. Let us be seated as we listen to the Word of God. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother, or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we all shall stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would have I told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Since Paul loved Coca-Cola, I thought he might like that during his funeral, that hallelujah that had that piece there. And since he loved humor, I'm thinking about my favorite epitaph that I've ever heard of. I've never seen it because it's all the way over in Scotland. But this particular grave, this man named Martin Elginbrod, his epitaph says, "Here lies Martin Elginbrod. Be good to me, Lord God." Because that's what I would do if I were Lord God and you were Martin Elginbrod. What I like about that is that Martin Elginbrod not only had a sense of humor, but what I like about it is that he had a pretty good sense of theology and a good understanding of God, too. You know, moments like this, as family comes together and as you surround each other and support each other. In Canada, I don't know why we don't have it in ours, but in the Catholic Church in Canada, in their ritual book that gets used, it says at a funeral, the last prayer, it says, "May every sign of friendship and affection and compassion that you receive in these days, may it be a glimpse of God. Love and care and compassion, first of all for Paul and for each of you." As your family gathers here, as your mom was telling me, Jason, you just shared with your dad your grades and all and finishing law school. And it brought me back to the fact, and being here today, just think, my dad died 30 years ago. But I was right on the verge of being ordained a priest. It was as in my last days of seminary and right before. And my dad had his first grandchild, you know, and it seemed so unfair that he went because there was so much ahead, you know. But I don't know about Paul, but one of the things that, even though my dad would have needed heart surgery, and heart surgery even then was pretty routine, I sort of convinced myself, I said, my dad wouldn't want to go through all that lied ahead. You know, my dad was basically a wimp with doctors. And I didn't think my dad would do well with things that, even if they're routine for others. But it seems that so much might have lied ahead for Paul, that even as the shock of this is difficult to deal with, that in some way we could still bless God's mercy in some way, that he didn't have to go through more. And we give thanks to God. I remember on that day of my father's funeral, thinking about the fact that some people pack more living into fewer years, you know? And Paul certainly enjoyed life. And also, even though it seems not the right moment to me and incomplete in terms of your family story and your family life, you know, just as he was a provider and took care of his family, in a certain way, just as I felt at that moment, I looked at the big picture and I thought to myself, his work was done. You know, his work was done. You know, the beautiful 44 years of marriage, you know, getting both of you, you know, to that point now. You know, your mom gets to enjoy the beautiful legacy that is, you know, the two of them together. And yet, make no mistake about it, he'll be enjoying it, every bit of it, from that beautiful vantage point of heaven. Proud, you know, proud, rejoicing, sharing in everything, more present than he could have been. As I was talking to Linda on Monday, I was thinking as I was listening to the story of what happened, I was thinking about one of our parishioners who, when I first got here to the parish, he was a quadriplegic. He had been in an accident, and his kids were still growing up, and he ended up unable to work and at home being cared for. And it always shocked me. He would say to me, it was the greatest blessing of my life. You know, and he said, I was so busy, I got to see everything. I got to really spend time, you know, with my kids. And one of the beautiful things is the gift of the way, because of these weird circumstances, that you've been able to be with your dad and to spend so much time with him and take care of him in such a beautiful way. You know, one of the things in all that lies ahead is you can't be both in Florida and you can't be here. And you can't spend every moment with your grandson and with other, you know, kids we pray to come as well in your family. You know, you can't do everything, but now we can. Now we can enjoy every bit of it all from that vantage point of the kingdom of God. We give thanks to God for all the living that he did pack into those years. We give thanks to God for all these years that you got to enjoy in Florida. We give thanks to God today for the gift of family and the incredible gift of your family, but the way that Paul was so much a part of it and all of the heartfelt love in the family. We give thanks to God for the legacy that is his in his son and in his daughter and in your family, you know, as well. We give thanks to God for all that lies ahead and for the way that all that lies ahead, you know, is so much because of what he did and how he lived and what he did to take care of his family. We give thanks to God for it all on this day, for the gift of his life. And I began with that quote from Martin Elgin brought on his epitaph. You know, be good to me, Lord God, because that's what I would do if I were Lord God and you were Martin Elginbrod. You know, not only do we want to be rooted today in God's goodness and God giving heaven to Paul, but we give thanks to God for the way that Paul lived out what God called him to. As a husband in these 44 years, as a father, as a grandfather, you know, in his family, caring for others, with his funny spirit, being able to lift others up, we give thanks to God for the beautiful gift of this life. And we entrust them to God. When I put that cross on Paul's casket at the beginning of the Mass, you know, the church gives me the words to say that in his life, Paul knew the cross of Jesus Christ. may he share in its victory. And he did know that cross. And he knew that cross, really, we could say, in just having God for a biopsy, he was sharing in the cross. But he knew the cross in really the best, the daily ways that he sacrificed and provided and cared for his family that he loved. And we give thanks to God for the blessings of all the love that you gave him and surrounded him with. But I felt uniquely as I placed it there, thinking about all that could have lied ahead and the suffering. We thank God that he doesn't need to know that. But instead, even as he shared in that cross, he gets to share in its victory, in its victory. You know, I know that bringing him here was with this sense of humor, maybe it's important to say this. I wonder if he really wanted to come back to Pennsylvania, you know, the sense that it was from step one till the end. It wasn't easy, you know, for it. It wasn't easy at all for that to happen. But the journey like this and the church's funeral procession, coming, you know, from the way that you surrounded him with love at home, and then coming here to this church, and then going to the cemetery, really that journey is meant to remind us that what life is all about, you know, that we're on a journey, and that heaven, that God who loves has a home for us in heaven. The gospel I just read, it's such a beautiful family image of, in my Father's house, there's many dwelling places. Jesus said that knowing the reality of the Middle East, I've seen the archaeology in a dangerous place that was dangerous then and is now. A father would add rooms onto his house as he had kids so that their family could be there, so that they could be family, so that they could share a table, so that they could know protection, so that they could be cared for. It's a beautiful family image that God gives us in that gospel of assuring us that just as Paul and Linda created a home together, and just as the gift of your large family, but then the gift of the family that the two of you created as well. Now God says to Paul, well done, well done. Come, share my table. Come, come be at home. Blessed are they who die in the Lord. May Paul rest from his labors. May all of his good deeds and all the love that he knew and gave, may it be forever. Let us stand and we'll make some prayers to the Lord, and our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. In thanksgiving for Paul's life and for the blessing of family, we pray to the Lord that the Lord will surround your family with love and care, that every sign of friendship and affection and care that you receive might be a sign of God's love and care. We pray to the Lord. That how quickly Paul was taken from us might always be a reminder of how precious life is. And may we seek to live life fully each day and to love as best we can. We pray to the Lord. We pray that we might be renewed in our faith and in the gift of God's love. We pray to the Lord for Paul and for all of our loved ones who have gone before us, that they might be with all the saints and angels in the glory of heaven. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, we thank you for Paul's life, and we entrust him into your arms of love and mercy through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us be seated.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Paul may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Paul, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus is our resurrection and our life, and we pray as he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. With faith in your love and mercy, body and soul, may we not be in condemnation, but the help of mind and body. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. There'll be ushers who will direct you to Holy Communion. I'll be giving communion first to this side of the church and then afterwards to that side of the church. This side first and then the other. Thank you. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Paul, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. In moments like this, I think God gives us little glimpses of his love. Paul went home to the Lord on Russian Christmas, his mother's heritage, you know, a little glimpse. I've always found beautiful solace in, there's a beautiful little book, The Little Prince, and it describes this little boy, it says, who's going away, and he says, it's actually a great trick I'm playing on you. You like my smile, my laughter. You know, I'm going to be there among the stars of the sky. When you look up at the stars of the sky, you won't know exactly where. It'll seem as if all the stars of the sky are smiling. All the stars of the sky are laughing. We give thanks to God for Paul's life. But as we entrust him to the Lord, may we know his presence with the Lord. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, recognize him as his own and take him in his arms in love and mercy and bring him to the Father's house. May he dwell with all the saints in blessedness and in peace. To your good hands, Father of mercies, we commend Paul in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Paul in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship of saints in Christ. Good and gracious and merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Paul and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Paul forever through Christ our Lord. In peace and in the sure hope of the resurrection, let us take Paul to his place of rest.
Will